I'm becoming a farmer like my father. I looked at my father and then looking the those dry field. I see the rest of my life becoming as a farmer. I didn't hate to become a farmer, but to become a farmer in such a way that only growing to live, no, never for profit. For me, it was a sad time, and then I really loved school, and then I decided that I'll do everything possible so that I can see the education. So what I did, I went to a library to start reading books, so that I was hoping that when the hunger would be over, maybe my parents could find money, and then they'll send me back to school. Then I should be in the same page with the students who are going to school by that time. But instead of only reading some school textbook, I was also interested in on science books, and then even though I couldn't read English that well, so most of the time I was using the diagrams and then reading the words around them. My favorite topic that time was electromagnetics, and then I learned how electromagnetics work, and I learned something about bicycle dynamo, how bicycle dynamo works to generate just things like that.
Could you explain what the bicycle dynamo is and how you would kind of fool around with it? How did that spark your creativity?
A bicycle dynamo is a small generator on the bike which generates electricity when somebody is riding a bicycle with the dynamo to make a light on the bicycle headlamp. So what was happening was that before that time I was able to fix radios, so I came obsessed with the electricity because when I was fixing radios, I was using batteries, but most of the time I didn't have money to buy batteries, so I was just using used batteries together, making a line of them, 10 or 8 of them together to fix radios.
You're buying dead batteries in the garbage.
Yeah, so I was most interested to learn about electricity, and then after the time goes by, I learned how I found somebody with a bicycle with a dynamo, and then I played around with it to test if I can use the dynamo to power a radio. One time when I was playing with it with my cousin, I found out that it was working. It was able to power him. A radio with the paddling through the paddling motion when the dynamo is spinning. So basically, that's what happened. And then the other book, which I continued going to the library, and the other book had a pictures of the windmill on the cover. And then when I opened inside, there wasn't a diagram how we can do the windmill, but they said that windmill to pump water and generate electricity. Pump water for me attracted my attention, and I said that if I can pump water, then I can be able to start irrigation. Then I can be growing maize, or corn, three or two times a year. Then my family will no longer go hungry again. And then I said that maybe this one can be solution for the problem we are facing. And then I started to think how I can build one to pump water. But instead of building one to pump water, I didn't have money to buy materials to build the windmill to pump water. So what I did, I went to the junkyard where I found most of my materials. The first thing which I found, I found the tractor fan, which I used as a lot of the windmill. I also found the using the bicycle frame for the frame of the windmill. I found the shock absorber, which I used as the shaft of the windmill. And for the blade of the windmill, I found the PVC pipes, which I cut them and then melt them over the fire and then stretching them to give the blades. And then I took all these things together and then putting them together, I was able to make the windmill, which was able to generate electricity. For the tower, the windmill, I used a plugum trees for the poles.
And about your generator, what happened?
Yeah, so for the generator to generate electricity, my friend bought it for me because I didn't have money to buy one for myself, and my friend helped me to buy it.
So how long did it take you to find all these materials? And as you were in the scrapyard, what must people be saying about you? I mean, what did your parents think?
Yeah. As I was going to a junkyard collecting all these materials, and then my parents, my mom thought that I was crazy, including people around in the area. They thought that maybe I was smoking marijuana. they say that because they say that it wasn't normal for a normal person going to a junkyard and then collecting all these garbages and putting them in his room, saying that I want to build a windmill, and then people in that area, they don't know what windmill was, and then it was like a strange thing. That's why they were saying that I'm going crazy. So I kept on working on it, even though people were saying all those things.
And so you finally found it. After how many months did it take you to?
Yeah, it took me about 3 months to build the windmill. The other challenge which I faced was that the materials, the tools which I was using to build the windmill, I didn't have any tools, so I was using everything I found. For a hammer, I was just using a big spanner which I was banging, and then if I want to drill some holes, I was just hitting the nail on the fire and then driving that nail on a PVC pipe. But it was a slow process because I could heat up a nail here, taking it where I want to drill it to. Then the time I'll be reaching the place where I want to drill it, I would then go and land and go back and forth. It was like that. So,
so after several months, you finally were able to find a generator, and your friend Gilbert, just kind of by such a nice guy like you guys, were walking down the road from the training center to your house, and he sees a guy with a dynamo on a bicycle, and that was your last piece, right? I mean, you had built everything, and but we were just kind of waiting on that, and Gilbert, is being the nice guy he is, volunteered to buy this windmill. I mean, it's a generator for about 200 quattro, which is $1.50, you know. And his working family didn't have any money. And so describe what it was like when you finally had that, one of my favorite stories, when you finally had that dynamo in your hand, you're clutching it after thinking about it for so long. What did you do?
Yeah, when I finally got the dynamo, I was very happy. I remember when we take off the dynamo from the bike, I just grabbed it from my friend, and then I said that this is the piece which I was looking for, and I started running to my house, and then it was like I was celebrating because I know that if I couldn't find it, then what I've been working on, it was just useless thing without a dynamo, because I couldn't generate any electricity. The people were saying that I was going crazy, then they really proved to me that I was really crazy. So it was the hardest time for me.
So you ran up and you attached that dynamo to the machine, and a crowd gathered because they saw you climbing this tower, and they were still laughing at you, and they were still doubting you.